scientists have discovered evidence of phosphorus in an ocean not on Earth. A new study in the journal Nature says the life-sustaining element was found inside salty ice grains shot into space from Enceladus, one of the Saturn's moons. It's not only is it phosphorus vital to all life on Earth, but its existence supports the idea of an ocean beneath the icy surface of the moon capable of supporting life. Just because it's capable of supporting life does not mean that there is life. The co-author of the study says, quote, "The next step is clear. We need to go back to see if the habitable ocean is actually inhabited." Joining me now from San Antonio, Texas, is Christopher Glein, a planetary scientist, geochemist and co-author of the study. Thank you for being with us.
Hi, John. I'm happy to be with you.
That's great. Okay, I'm about to read three different headlines for you about this discovery. At the end of it, tell me which one best describes what this is all about. Okay, from space.com, first ever detection of phosphorus shows that Enceladus, I keep getting that wrong, has all necessary ingredients for life. Okay, from The Independent has this. Major finding on Saturn's moon boosts hopes of finding alien life in our solar system. And then we have this from the good folk at the Daily Mail. They ask, are aliens hiding on Saturn's moon? Scientists discover phosphates and say it could be a sign of life. Okay, so is it ingredients for life, increased chance of finding alien life, or the aliens are actually hiding on Saturn's moon?
Right. So there's a lot to unpack there. It's definitely an ingredient for life. It's one of the big six elements that life uses. So it makes the environment habitable, what scientists call it. Those are the conditions that can support life. And if you have those conditions that can support life, that gives you better odds of finding life. But we cannot yet say that we know or do not know if Enceladus has life.
Okay, so Saturn has what, 146 moons at last count? How is this discovery made on Enceladus, especially since it wasn't really something you were looking for, nor did you expect?
Right. We had a mission there about 10 years ago named Cassini. It did a lot of great science. There were different models suggesting that phosphorus could be very rare or more abundant, so we weren't really quite sure what to expect. And then over the past few years, this team I was a part of, led by Frank Postberg, we started looking at the data from the Cassini mission, and we found the telltale signs of phosphorus contained in the chemical data of material that spewed out of Enceladus's ocean.
So the New York Times sort of breaks down the importance like this. It's kind of a good write. They say phosphorus is a key ingredient in human bones and teeth. And scientists say it's the rarest bioessential ingredient in the cosmos. Planetary researchers have previously detected the other five key elements on Enceladus: carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, and sulfur. Although they're a bit dodgy on the sulfur part right now. If this potentially habitable ocean was in fact inhabited, what sort of life form would be there? What would it look like?
Right. So we're a long way from answering the question if it's inhabited. We'll need a new mission to do that. But from what we know from the data, the kinds of life that could be supported under these conditions would be microbes. So they could be organisms that would be either at the bottom of the ice sheet near the surface, or they could be at the bottom of Enceladus's ocean at the seafloor, perhaps next to what we think are hydrothermal vents at the seafloor. Those would be the kinds of environments that are very dynamic, where a lot of ingredients would be mixed in and would be most favorable for supporting life.
We have a thing here. We like to play movie clips whenever we do kind of, you know, segments about space. And in the movie Total Recall, we should note that Saturn apparently was a hot destination of choice. Watch this.
To be perfectly honest with you, Doug, if outer space is your thing, I think you would be much happier with one of our Saturn cruises. Everybody raves about them.
Now, I'm not interested in Saturn. I said Mars.
Wants to go to Mars. So, I guess, so if Enceladus may be able to support life, it doesn't seem capable of supporting human life. That's right?
Well, if we wanted to have humans go there, and I don't think that would be our first step into the solar system, we would need the kinds of life-supporting systems like you need on other planetary bodies where, you know, like if we go to the moon or Mars, we'd have to have self-sustaining systems to keep people alive.
But the fact there is water there is obviously, you know, something which can then be used to sustain some kind of human settlement. Is that right?
It could be, yeah. The surface of Enceladus is frozen. It's very bright water ice. So there's a lot of water that's available there as ice on the surface and then liquid water down a few miles below the surface.
Yeah, not exactly our first stop into the universe, right? Well, beyond the moon, I guess. But Christopher, thank you so much for being with us. We really appreciate it. Congratulations on your discovery. It's been described as one of the biggest in the last 25 years. So well done.
Thank you, John.